In Cuba, authorities begin restoring power to the eastern half of the island a day after Hurricane Rafael left 10 million people in the dark. The storm knocked out the country's electric grid as it tore across Cuba with winds of up to 185 kilometers per hour, uprooting trees and damaging countless homes. The country's energy minister says progress is being made in power restoration efforts, but warns the process would be slower in western parts of Cuba, which were hardest hit by the storm. Rafael was the second hurricane to hit the island in less than a month after Oscar ravaged eastern Cuba in October.
President Marcos issues an executive order officially banning offshore gaming operations in the country. EO 74 orders an immediate ban of POGOs, internet gaming, and other offshore gaming operations in the Philippines. The president cited a study by the finance department, which noted the risks and negative consequences of POGOs outweigh their economic and social benefits. The signing of the EO comes months after the president announced the blank POGO ban during his third State of the Nation address. He also gave POGO operators until the end of the year to leave the Philippines.
Cassandra Ong has asked the House Quad Committee to allow her friend to stay with her while she's detained at the Correctional Institution for Women in Mandaluyong. Abang Lingkod Party Leader's Representative Joseph Stephen Paduano read Ong's letter of request during the House Quad Committee hearing Thursday. Paduano said Ong is suffering from severe mental breakdown and anxiety attacks and is currently in a state of severe depression. House QuadCom overall chairperson Robert Ace Barber said they would look into Ong's request and discuss it with the Correctional Institution for Women. Ong, an authorized representative of Lucky South 99, was cited in contempt on September 19 for the second time for lying.
Do not scare me. That's the message of former President Rodrigo Duterte to lawmakers who have threatened to cite him in contempt for failure to attend the House Quad Committee's inquiry into his drug war. Duterte had been repeatedly invited to the panel's hearings. But the former chief executive revealed he could not attend the hearing since traveling to Manila from Davao City is costly for him. The House Quad Committee is investigating alleged extrajudicial killings in Duterte's war on illegal drugs. On Thursday, panel co-chair Congressman Joseph Paduano voiced his dismay over Duterte's absence and even asked if the former president is scared of appearing before the lower house.
Philippine officials encourage more foreigners to retire here in the country through visa programs for retirees and investors. Our North America correspondent Steve Angeles with the details.
As the Philippines continues to earn the reputation of a retirement and investment destination, Philippine officials are making a push for non-Filipino citizens and those that are not dual citizens to avail of a special retirees visa.
The country is booming and that there are real positive developments and opportunities. I know that many of you here in the U.S. are considering retirement in the Philippines.
Yes.
Perhaps you also know of many other Americans, especially non-Filipinos, who are also considering this as well. So in making this a consideration, you may also be thinking about the possible downsides of retiring in the Philippines.
The Philippine Retirement Authority met with the Filipino-American community in Los Angeles to promote the Special Residence Retirees Visa. This program is nothing new. In fact, it's been around for nearly 40 years, with some 80,000 people already availing of the visa. China has had the most number of enrollees since the program began, with the U.S. taking fourth place. The Philippine government is making sure more people know about it and its long-term benefits.
It has the option of permanency when you have this visa. It lets you stay there for as long as you want. We don't require a certain period of time when you have to be there. It's a multiple entry and indefinite stay kind of program. You can come in and out as you please. It exempts you from, because you have your own ID, it would exempt you from getting the ACR card. It's called the retirement visa, but it's a well-rounded program that allows you to work, enter into a gainful employment. It allows you to do investment, and it's a study visa for students, because it's a kind of visa that is planned for allowing to bring in dependents, spouses and children included.
Eligible participants have to be at least 50 years old and must complete medical examinations. Submit police and NBI clearance along with the payment and fees. Contact your local Philippine consulate for more information and to apply. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News, Los Angeles.